exactly 10 years to the day after a statement revealed she had split from long-term boyfriend Olivier Martinez, Kylie Minogue posted an emotive image of a sunrise over calm waters to Instagram, informing her followers another relationship was over. This time it's not just a boyfriend the singer has split from but her fiancé of 2 years. Joshua Sassamid claims he grew close to a TV show co-star. With characteristic optimism, Kylie insisted, "We wish only the best for each other as we venture towards new horizons." The hashtag reiterated her positivity, hashtag the sun always rises. But it must have been difficult for a singer so famous for a lucky in love lyric to open her heart again to reveal yet another relationship had broken down. Friends believe she has been fortunate, insisting the 48-year-old has had lucky escape by not marrying the dad of one. One said, "Josh pretty much lived a double life. With Kylie, he was domesticated and insisted he was ready to settle down. But behind her back, he was a party boy. He lived a wild lifestyle and would boast about how his association with Kylie opened doors for him and bragged about money and fame. Some feared he was just using her." After a series of bros ahead of Kylie traveling to Paris Fashion Week at the start of the year, reports claim the "I Should Be So Lucky" star grew suspicious of his blossoming friendship with Spanish actress Marta Milans. It has been suggested the pair bonded while filming the romantic comedy No Tomorrow in Vancouver, Canada, last year. However, today, the 34-year-old's brother, Alfonso, insisted the claims were totally foreign to him. To say her love life has been complicated would be an understatement. Kylie's first public romance with Jason Donovan, but this time, it was Kylie who dumped her neighbor's on and off-screen lover via a phone call. After she met INXS singer Michael Hutchence in 1989, she was immediately bowled over by the late Bad Boy's opening gambit. "I don't know what we should do first. Have lunch or have sex?" Her squeaky clean image was immediately tainted by the drug-taking rock star, who famously quipped his hobby was corrupting Kylie Minogue. The pair reportedly romped on a plane while sitting behind then-Australian Prime Minister Bob Hawke, and Kylie has said she enjoyed a lot of firsts with her lover. "He was Byron-esque, he was poetic, he was cultured and hilarious and tender," she has said, with one biographer stating her struggles with lover because she's never found anyone to live up to him. When he left her for Danish supermodel Helena Christensen, 48, after 18 months in 1991 she was devastated but rebounded with another rocker, Lenny Kravitz, the same year. In 1999, she would embark on a 3-year relationship with British model James Gooding, but her heart was broken when he not only cheated on her, but told the story of flying to New York to sleep with model Sophie Dahl behind her back. It was James that claimed Kylie was difficult in a relationship, citing her obsession with career success as a major issue. In an interview in 2003, he blasted her as being a self-obsessed, virtually friendless control freak of her then-fledgling relationship with French actor Olivier Martinez. He scoffed, "She'll have to change if she wants it to work. I fear she's going to end up a lonely spinster with only a cat by her side for company." Olivier would become Kylie's rock when the singer was dealt the devastating diagnosis of breast cancer in 2005, days before she was due to embark on the Australian leg of her Showgirls tour. He moved her into his 2-bedroom flat in Paris as she recovered from radiotherapy and chemotherapy at the Institut Gustave Roussy, and the following year, she said of him, "Oli was there all the time, helping with the practical stuff and being protective. He was incredible. He didn't hesitate in canceling work and putting projects on hold so he could be with me." He's the most honorable man I have ever met. But the relationship was then dogged with cheating rumors. A 24-year-old Israeli model, Sarah Gavati, revealed she enjoyed three wonderful nights with Olivier. When the model was spotted heading into LA's Chateau Marmont where he was staying, Kylie reportedly gave him an ultimatum to settle down or split. In January 2007, just days prior to their split, Olivier met up with Sarah as well as Lost star Michelle Rodriguez in LA. But the former couple hit out at false claims of disloyalty in their split statement, which said they had parted amicably after 5 years together. Indeed, Kylie would continue to meet up with Olivier in Paris over the coming years. In 2008, following rumors of a tryst with David Tennant, she hooked up with Spanish model Andres Belencoso after meeting on the set of her Perfume advert. At 38, he was a decade younger than the star. In 2012, she stated, "He's the one. Sound the alarm, 4 years. I'm pretty settled." But they split the following year, leaving her so heartbroken, she reportedly cried herself to sleep for months. Spending the next 18 months single seemed to take their toll on the star. In March 2014, when asked what her greatest fear was, she replied, "Loneliness," and said her happiest moment had been "when I was in love." Speaking candidly in an interview in May 2015 shortly before she would be linked to pal Chris Martin, she vowed she would find someone to fall in love with, no matter what shape he came in. "I don't mind gray hair. I don't mind bald. I don't even mind a bit of a paunch. Maybe too good looking is where I've been going wrong." However, she appears not to have listened to her own advice. That summer, she set eyes on hunky 29-year-old Joshua, the son of late poet Dominic and Mary Macaulay, the granddaughter of Viscount William Barry, who funded Sir Winston Churchill, as they filmed the musical comedy Gallivant together. She admits she'd subtly let him know she liked him, and within weeks they were dating, and he described her as a bundle of sex and joy. The couple also faced criticism for their 20-year age gap, and Kylie told The Mirror she found the term "toy boy" offensive, and insisted age was no issue for the couple. By December, she was declaring, "I'm completely in love." Joshua, who attended the £10,000 a year Shrewsbury School before studying performing arts, claimed he was ignorant to the star's career, which spans three decades and has seen her sell over 80 million records. "I'm not really a fan of popular culture," he said as their relationship developed. "Frankly, I really didn't know who she was. I'm not really her demographic." Yet his celebrity girlfriend status became quickly apparent, and he publicly grumbled about his new moniker, Mr. Minogue. It later emerged that he had fathered a son, 4-year-old Sebastian, with his Italian ex, Francesca Cini, who he referred to as his wife. That Christmas, as Kylie released a festive album and enthusiastically spoke about her new man on the promo trail, Joshua met her parents, accountant Ron and former dancer Carol, and younger brother Brendan at a gig at the Royal Albert Hall in December 2015. Having said he was nervous prior to the meeting, he appeared confident in his relationship when he walked out on stage to join her as she received a standing ovation from the crowd. In subsequent interviews, she wept tears of joy as he read out a sensual poem written by his late father, who died in a plane crash when Joshua was just 5, during her appearance on BBC Radio 4's Desert Island Discs. Just weeks ago, Kylie gushed that she wanted to take her husband to be surnamed. "When I look into Josh's eyes, he is all I see and that makes me very happy," she cooed, but tellingly, she hinted the pair had no plans to get married. Despite Joshua presenting her with a ring and asking her to marry him a year ago, "I'm happy enjoying being engaged," she said. There's no pressure. My mom isn't buying a hat. Just weeks later, her online post read, "Thank you for all your love and support throughout this recent chapter of my life. Thank you now for your love and understanding with the news that Josh and I have decided to go our separate ways.